God, you are so good. Amen. Let me tell you something. You could probably be like, I don't really feel like reading the Bible today. I don't really feel like being fully committed to God. I don't feel like going to church. I don't feel like da 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 da. Let me tell you something. It's really funny because God can say that about you too. God can say, you know what? I'm not really going to focus on this person or really work on this person. If he ever said that about you, you could possibly end up being dead. Homeless. I don't know. It could be the worst things ever. You could probably get possessed. You could probably lose your job, money, whatsoever. Your life will go down the drain if God ever said that about you. So if you over here saying that about God, he could say that about you too. But you know what? He doesn't choose to. Because he loves you. And he wants to keep on working with you. Because he wants you to get closer to him. He wants you to get on your knees and pray to him and talk to him. He would never say that to you. But you will say that to God?
What is going on, guys? I need you to share this for real with everyone. I need this to blow up. So I had a vision on Sunday. I was in prayer and then I went to praise and worship with my mom. And I was shouting, and then after that, I got drained because the Holy Spirit drained you. So I laid down, and when I closed my eyes, I came before the Lord. And when I came before him, he said, "Did you live for me?" And I said, "Yes, God." He said, "What? Why should you go to heaven?" And I said, "Because of what you did on earth." And he said, "Did you spread my word?" And I said, "Yes, Lord." He said, "Well done, my goodness, faithful servant." Then he said, "Look, let me show you something." He said, "Look left." When I looked to the left, bottom left, I seen hell. And all I seen was just these black shadow empty souls just stepping over a cliff, falling into a never endless pit of fire. And it looked like lava, but it was hotter than that. And soon as I looked there, my heart sank to the bottom of my stomach and I could have no feelings. And all I instantly said, "Jesus." And he drawed my attention back and he said, "Heaven or hell, which one do you choose?" And I said, "Heaven." And he negated.
This is my body. This is my blood. I'm going to the Father, but I will always be with you. Now I must tell you that one of you here will betray me.
Guys, I really need you to spread the awareness that hell isn't a joke. Use this sound however you want. Billions are burning in hell. Do you know how hot hell is? It's sad to see people worshiping Satan. You get raped, you get tortured, you get stabbed. You can't even see your relatives or yell for help sad face though. Aren't you scared? Spread the gospel. Reminder: stop sinning. We need people to spread the awareness. Hell isn't safe. Hell is torture. Heaven is a whole different story. You can hang out with God and Jesus.
Jesus is coming back very soon, alright? How do you guys not see how corrupted our government is today? They take God out of schools, and now if you're a Christian, you should be ashamed, right? It's all, "Don't force your religion on us until it's not a Christian anymore," right? Look, bro, Jesus said before he comes back, nations will rise against nations. Do you know what nations translates to? Nations translates to races, alright? And what's going on right now? Black lives matter. No, white lives matter. No, Hispanic lives matter. I got on TikTok today and I seen a big old anti-fascist riot because Trump lost. People was fighting, they was pulling knives out, destroying stuff. Just like the Black Lives Matter movement. Jesus is coming back, okay? Everything he says in that book, in that Bible, is happening right now. Wake up, bro. Quit lying to yourself. You don't want to quit the sin that you're doing, so to cope with that, you say there is no God. You're about to see, my friend.
If you believe in God, just stop scrolling just for a minute, because what I'm about to say can really speak to you or someone else, so share this video. Now, there are people in this world, right? They know God, they believe in Him, they know He's real, they know He's there, but they don't live for Him. They don't walk according to His purpose, and they post stuff about Him on their social media saying that He's laying His plan out for their life. But how is He supposed to do that when you're living in total wickedness, when you're hanging out with people that are leading you on the wrong path, when you are drinking and smoking on a daily basis, when you are not even trying to create a relationship with Him and turn away from your ways? He cannot just walk into our life and just scoop us up and say, here we go, because you have to open that door. You have to let Him in. You have to speak to Him and start a relationship with Him. You really want God to lay out His plan for your life? Then walk according to His purpose. Live for Him on a daily basis. Let go of your wicked ways and follow Him. And that's when you'll really get to know who God is and His plan for your life.
Wait for one moment. Before you scroll, allow me to say a powerful afternoon prayer for you right now. And when I'm done praying for you, share with three other people. You never know who you're going to bless, encourage, and uplift. All because you decided to share. Are you ready? Let's pray. Father God, I pray for my brother and my sister who's watching me across the screen this afternoon. Be with them. I pray whatever's on their mind, whatever's on their heart, whatever they're facing right now, that you will bring them through. I pray in Jesus' name that you guide their decision making. I pray if they're far from you, that today they draw closer to you. Speak to them like never before. Work in their life like never before. Allow the fire of the Holy Ghost to be in their life right now. In Jesus' mighty name, let everyone say amen.
Fix your focus. You're too worried about what other people are going to say about you rather than what God is going to say about you. If God says do this and do that, and you're too worried about, I don't know what they're going to say about me, you got it all wrong. You're twisted and you're stuck in a box. I'm telling you, get up out of there. For real, when I done came to this walk and I started walking for Christ, a whole lot of people don't show me fake love. Yo, what's up, E? And then talk behind my back, talking about he a goody-goody this. Yeah, I'm a goody-goody this. I done switched my life up for the right reasons, and you're still stuck, not knowing what to do with your life, not striving, and still lost. But what you gotta do, you gotta pray for those people and hope that God opens their vision like He did with you. Because little do they know, you're growing, you're doing bigger things because you're called by the Almighty God. And that's the difference. That's the difference. So get up out of the mentality that whatever they're saying about you is more important than what God is saying about you. Strive, grow, do better, focus on yourself, and focus on God.
You're in the process of becoming what God wants you to be. See, the reason you wake up every day, the reason you keep waking up, is because God ain't through with you yet. If God was through with you, you wouldn't wake up no more. But He keeps waking you up because He still has something for you that you've yet to receive. But you have to start living your life in expectation. You have got to start expecting great things to happen for you in order for it to happen. It is the law of attraction. It is real. It is nothing fake about it. The Bible says a man is as he thinketh. If you live your life in expectations, that's what happens to you. If you live your life in despair, that's what happens to you. If you say all men are dogs, you're gonna meet every last one of them.
We're not going to heaven because we're good. We're not going to heaven because we work. We're not going to heaven because we pay. We're going to heaven because of what He did on the cross, and all I have to do is receive it. And it's so simple to receive Christ that millions stumble over its very simplicity. You see, God made it so simple that children can believe. He made it so simple and so easy that a blind man, a deaf man, a dumb man can believe. A man of any race can believe. A man of any nationality, of any language can believe. And that's all God says you have to do to get to heaven. Just believe. Now, that word believe is a little more than maybe you think it is. It means commitment. It means surrender. It means that I give everything I have to Jesus Christ and trust Him alone for my forgiveness and my salvation. It means that the moment you receive Him, your name is written in the book of life. Is your name in the book of life? Are you sure you're going to heaven? Are you prepared to meet God?
Jesus is coming so soon. Guys,
Stop being scared to preach the gospel. Stop being scared. Because on that day of judgment, where we're all in a line, ready to be judged by God, out of everything we have done. Imagine you see that person that God wanted you to tell about God, but you were too scared. And you hear God's loud voice saying, "Depart from me, for I never knew you." But you knew him. And you knew what he wanted you to do. And God wanted you to spread the word to them so bad. But because of your selfish desires, that was a loss. Spread the gospel.
That God is about to bring a miracle out of your circumstance. All of those areas in your life by where are that are dry, that seem to be going in cyclical cycles, by where there's no productivity, God says, "I'm literally about to bring a miracle out of your situation." If you can just keep your head high for these next 30-something days, God says, "I'm about to bring a miracle out of your situation." And for those that laugh at you when you were in your dry season, and for those that laugh at you when you didn't have enough to make it, and for those that laughed at you when you were on the bus and living in a one bedroom, barely able to pay the rent, and for those that laughed at you, God says, "I'm about to bring a miracle out of your situation." The Bible says that the woman came near Elisha and stood in the doorway. Number three, God says he's about to set you in new doorways. Whatever place you were in before, prepare to move to a new place.
Hey, hold up. I got good news for you. Great news, in fact. Probably the best news you have ever heard. Did you know that there is nothing you can do to earn God's love and approval? If you're a Christian, share this message with as many people as possible, because there is absolutely nothing that you can do, that I can do, that anybody can do to earn God's grace. See, the Bible says, "For all have sinned and fallen short of the glory of God, and therefore are justified freely by his grace." It also says, "For it is by grace you have been saved through faith, and not of yourselves. It is a gift of God, not of works, so that no one can boast." You see, religion says do, and then God will love you. But Jesus says, the gospel says done. You are already accepted by God on the basis of the life, the death, and the resurrection of Jesus. So when you believe on the name of Jesus for the forgiveness of your sin, God establishes your righteousness. So when God sees you, he doesn't see your sin. He only sees his son, whom you have believed in, his perfect, spotless, and righteous son. Somebody comment grace if you'll give God some praise.
Jesus doesn't hate you. Yes, you watching this, he does not hate you. You're not too far gone for Jesus or his love. That's a lie, and I want to show you the truth. I want to break that lie. Would you share this video with someone who needs to hear this and hear the truth? Jesus is full of mercy and love. When I look at Jesus, I see a man of such humility, a man who laid down everything. He was God, laid down everything, became a man, and died for those who hated him, for those who rebelled against him, for those who didn't understand who he was or the truth that he presented. He loved them, and he loves you. But will you choose to receive that love?
Whoa, 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 stop. In the name of Jesus Christ, stop scrolling. This message is for you, and it's one that you want to hear. Jesus Christ, the Son of God, his blood is so thick that it can wash over any sin. That you have committed. So right now, type, "I give my life to Jesus Christ." Amen. Hallelujah. Glory be to God. the Holy Spirit will be sent to you. You'll feel goosebumps, you'll feel a warmness in your heart, you'll feel giddy, you'll feel joy, you'll feel tears, you'll feel sorry, you'll feel every single thing in once. That's the Holy Spirit. Follow this feeling. It will lead you to salvation. Glory be to God. Thank you for sharing. Sharing the word is good. Glory be to God.
I don't know who needs to hear this, but I'm here to tell you God walked into that room before you even thought about walking into it. What preach, Leah? If you feel right now in this season of your life right now where you may feel alone, where you may feel like people have turned their backs on you, you may feel like that you're the only one rocking right now. You rocking solo right now. But I'm here to tell you right now, it's because God heard some conversations that you didn't hear. Because God felt some spirits that you didn't feel. Because God was in some rooms where some conversations were going on and you didn't even know they were talking about you. But God heard it all and he felt their spirit. You want to know why a relationship or a friendship didn't work? It's because God already knew their intentions for your life. And he said, what they're talking about in this room is not according to my plan. And it's thine will be done. It's God's will be done. So their conversations and their actions don't line up with God's actions. God will strip them out of your life. I love you.
Hey, I'm just going to be real with you. I'm going to go ahead and pray for your faith in just a second. So if you need prayer for your faith, stick with me. And if you don't, it's okay. I'm still going to pray for your faith. Share this video with others because anybody and everybody could use some prayer for their own faith. Even me sometimes. So Father, I pray in Jesus' name for whoever may be watching. I pray for their faith the same way that Jesus prayed for Peter, that his faith would not fail. I pray for the person in front of me right now. Jesus, increase faith. Strengthen faith, God. Would their faith stand the test of time, God. In Jesus' name, amen.
Proof of God, Part 8. Archaeological anomaly found at Mount Sinai. According to Scripture, the Lord God descended upon Mount Sinai with burning fire. And it's really quite interesting because we found Mount Sinai in Saudi Arabia, and it has a burnt mountain top. According to the locals, this is known as the Mountain of Moses. And there is currently no scientific explanation on why the top of Mount Sinai is burnt, like charcoal. And according to Scripture, at the bottom of Mount Sinai, the Israelites built an altar to a golden calf. And to our surprise, we found that altar right next to the mountain, as the Scripture declares. This altar has inscriptions of calves in it. What's more is that the Scripture declares that next to the altar of the golden calf, there are 12 marble pillars for animal sacrifices. We found those as well. We as Christians serve God Almighty.